السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. الحمد لله رب العالمين، الصلاة والسلام على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. Welcome to our new series on the life of the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. This is a series which is a favorite of mine. I have done this many times before and I hope to do it many times in the future, because the life of the Prophet, or the seerah of the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, is something which is as important as the Quran. And I don't say this carelessly. If we do not understand the seerah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, we cannot actually understand the Quran, because there are so many ayat of the Quran which are directly talking about and directly commenting on an incident that has just taken place in the life of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and the ayat come down and respond to them. So in order for us to understand the Quran, we need to understand the seerah. And in order for us to understand the seerah, we need to understand the Quran. So these two, they go intertwined together. And one of the companions, he said that we used to teach our children what happened in the life of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam like we used to teach them the Quran. And this was their understanding. And of course, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commands us in the Quran. He says, لَقَدْ كَانَ لَكُمْ فِي رَسُولِ اللَّهِ أُسْوَةٌ حَسَنَةٌ لِمَنْ كَانَ يَرْجُوا اللَّهَ وَالْيَوْمَ الْآخِرِ. That indeed there is for you a beautiful example, uswa hasana, an example for you to follow, for the one who hopes for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the last day, the one who hopes for good from Allah and on the last day, for them this is a beautiful example. And the only way we can follow this example is for us to follow and to learn the life of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. I hope that this series will be of benefit to adults, to the men, to the women. And I hope that this will also be beneficial to the younger children in our community and outside of our community as well. I hope that this will also be beneficial to non-Muslims who are looking to learn about Islam and the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. It is important to understand that when we study the seerah of the Prophet, or the life of the Prophet, and we're going to use this word seerah again and again, the word seerah refers to literally the footsteps left behind by the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So we are tracing life back by his footsteps. The seerah, or the life of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, was the greatest miracle, or the it was the miracle that the majority of the Sahaba saw. Okay, let me rephrase that. The majority of the Sahaba did not see supernatural miracles. The one miracle they saw, and that's why I said the word greatest, because the majority of the Sahaba only witnessed that one miracle. And that miracle was none other than the life of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And we will see this as we read the stories that happened in the time of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the events that took place, that the majority of the Sahaba, they did not see the moon splitting. They did not see some water flowing out, or the poison lamp speaking, and all of these type of things that we will talk about later. What they saw was a man with an impeccable character, who had never lied in his life, who was the most trustworthy person they could think of. And if this person is saying that I am a messenger of Allah and you need to follow me and I'm receiving revelation from Allah, this was enough for all of the people that became Muslim without seeing a miracle. And of course, among them are Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiyallahu an. Among them is Umar ibn al-Khattab radiyallahu an. Among them is Uthman ibn Affan. And Umar, of course, we can say that he heard the ayat of the Quran that affected him. But Uthman ibn Affan radiyallahu an, Ali radiyallahu an as a child, Khadija radiyallahu anha. These were not people who were soft-minded or feeble-minded. These were not people who could easily be swayed by someone who's saying, hey, come and follow me. These were smart, intelligent people before Islam. Khadija radiallahu anha, we all know, and we will learn more about her, what an amazing personality she was. She wouldn't believe in someone as a prophet of Allah if he wasn't truly a prophet of Allah. And what proof did she have for this, the truthfulness of this claim? It was the man in front of her, the life of the man in front of her, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So, with this introduction, with this short introduction, We begin with the name of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, which is the name Muhammad itself. The name Muhammad means the praised one, the praised one. Therefore, the Prophet's name is as much a title that describes the Prophet's qualities as it is a name that identifies the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam as an individual. It is important to understand the difference between names and titles. And of course, with the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, his name is something which is chosen by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and inspired to his parents and his mother and grandfather. However, sometimes people confuse this, and sometimes it is not appropriate for it to be a proper name. For example, the Prophet Muhammad is the praised one. One of the wives of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, her name was Barra, which means the righteous one, the righteous one. And of course, a righteous one is, it is better for it to be a title than it to be, than for it to be a name, that a person should earn that through their actions and not from their birth certificate. And in fact, when the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam would leave her house, the people would, you know, somebody would say, where is the Prophet? They would say, kharaja min barra, that he left righteousness. Kharaja, he left from righteousness, which doesn't come out right. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam actually changed her name to another name, which was then more appropriate, that he left the house of so and so. So when it comes to names, the Prophet's name is Muhammad, the one who is the praised one. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is of course filled with qualities that deserve praise. And he is the one who is the most praised person on the face of this earth. Any noble quality one can imagine, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam possessed it. He is divinely protected. He is the seal of all prophets. He is Allah's obedient slave. He is the chosen one from Allah's created beings. He is Allah's Khalil, the close friend. It denotes the highest level of friendship, the word Khalil. Therefore, he certainly deemed one who is worthy of being commended by Allah, praised by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, is deemed worthy of praise by people, for he is near to their hearts, merciful towards them, and blessed no matter where he is. He's worthy of praise because his character became refined through revelation, and because his personality became polished through prophethood. So this is, you know, the credentials of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that his qualification has been refined by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala himself. He was known by some other names as well. He was called Ahmad by Isa alayhi salam. He was called Ahmad by Isa alayhi salam. And Ahmad is the one who does the praise. Ahmad is the one. Isa alayhi salam gave glad tidings of him to his people, promising them that a prophet named Ahmad was soon to be going to be sent to mankind to teach them the truth. So, and Ahmad, as we said, is the one who is the praising one. So because he is Ahmad, and he praised so much in a, such a befitting manner, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave him the title of Muhammad, the one who is praised. So this is something that even in the names we have a lesson, that the one who praises Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala becomes the praised one. And of course, we cannot reach the level of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, but indeed, we can reach a very high level by continuously and sincerely and deeply from our heart praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And as we know that the Quran begins with the praise of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Some of the other names of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam that he himself mentioned are Al-Aqib, Al-Hashir, Al-Mahi. Al-Aqib means the one who succeeds others, or the one who comes after others. And of course, this is referring to the one who came after all of the prophets of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Al-Hashir connotes the meaning of resurrection, that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam will be given a special status on the day of resurrection, that he will be in such a status that the entire mankind would be resurrected at his feet. Meaning that he will be part of those resurrected on that day. However, he will be given a higher status than all of them. So it is as if that if you were to look up, the entire mankind is standing at the feet of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Also, the Prophet was called Al-Mahi, which is the one who erases something. And this refers to the Prophet ﷺ bringing the light of guidance to humanity and erasing the darkness of ignorance from the face of this earth as a result of the Quran that he brought and the teachings that he spread among the people. The Prophet ﷺ was mentioned in both the Torah and the Injil, the Gospel. Now, of course, we'd have some references, some of the Muslim scholars and some of the previous Christians and Catholics have written books, and they have given references of how the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is mentioned in the previous books. He was helped in his mission by Jibril, Jibril alayhi salam, and he carried the banner of honor for his family, and he was the most honored member of Banu Abdul Manaf ibn Qusay clan. And inshallah, we'll talk more about his clan in our next session and his birth. He was rightly guided himself. He was the best of guide for others. He was elevated in ranking by his Lord. He was thankful for all that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blessed him with. And he was and he continues to be a source of continuous, countless blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala upon the mankind. May the peace and blessings of Allah be upon him, upon his family, and upon his companions, as long as the stars appear in the sky, as long as the birds continue to sing, and as long as the wind continues to blow. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make this series a source in our good deeds. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make this weighty in the scale of our good deeds. And I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to let this series be an effort that He accepts and an effort through which the people find the way to the beloved Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and his beloved the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Subhanakallahumma wa bihamdik. Ashhadu an la ilaha illa ant. Astaghfiruka wa natubu ilayk.